Good morning, everybody. I think we are all here because we are sharing a common interest in a very special ecosystem that is a very hot, sometimes burning topic. And unfortunately for the peat, I mean, it's sort of you only hear about peat swamp and peat forest when they are burning. But in fact, they have a huge importance. And they have a huge importance to be kept effective functional ecosystem for biodiversity. They have a huge importance for ecosystem services. They have a huge importance for some water regulation, some impact on pollution. So, and they have also a disproportionate importance in terms of carbon storage. With the mangroves, and for some of you that were around, we had a couple of weeks ago a seminar on blue carbon, which is the carbon stored in mangrove, seagrass, and other coastal ecosystem. And mangroves and peat swamp are the ecosystems that are storing the most carbon, and as such play a very important role in potential greenhouse gases emission when they are degraded or destroyed. And unfortunately, a large amount of the tropical peat and peatlands have been destroyed. Some new areas have been discovered in Congo. There are large areas in the Amazon, but there are huge areas in Indonesia. This is the one we are going to discuss here during this dialogue. And I think for me, as forest ecologist, it's the utmost importance to conserve whatever we can conserve now in terms of peat. I mean, sort of, I don't think that development on peat is a good idea in general, especially on deep peat. And at the same time, we need to rehabilitate, restore the area that have been degraded. And to restore that, I mean, we need to be realistic also. It would probably be very difficult, if not impossible, to restore deep peat as it was before someone touches it. So we need to keep in mind that if we want to restore, it's a very difficult task, it's costly, and we will need the involvement of the private sector, and people will need to get something out of the restoration. Because if you don't remove the reason why the things have been degraded in the first instance, there is no point in restoring them. So I think it's all the thing that we probably want to discuss during this dialogue. We'll not speak longer because, as Daniel said, we have a lot of speakers and you are probably more interested in listening to the contents than someone making some generalities. Welcome to our nice campus. You are in the Global Forestry Hall of the C4 campus. Thank you all for coming. And before closing, I would just like to ask to give a few second thought of our Indonesian friends and colleagues that have been affected by the earthquake in Lombok. I know Pagus told me that the 4D office has been destroyed in Mataram. Think about them. They are in difficult thing. And our thoughts and our heart are with them. Thank you very much.